Welcome to part 3. Where are the assailants, you know, where are these attackers, yeah, getting police uniform? Yeah, that's the question we need to ask ourselves. Why is it that the trend is that these attackers, even where the police have been present, they have stood aside? Indeed, in one particular incident, something that happened in Kaungware 56, yeah, multiple eyewitnesses told us that the attackers were supervised by the police. This information is in the public domain. Yes, it has been reported in the press, yeah, in the printed media, several times. So it is not a secret or privileged information. It's a public information, which clearly points to the source of the violence. Okay? Now, in addition to that, NASA leader himself has clearly pointed to the government as a source of the violence and the killings. And he has widely been quoted by media houses right across the board. When you tie that in to the fact that in the most recent attacks, we were told that these guys in motorbikes who are killing people demanded the IDs first, yeah, before they pulled the trigger. Where would they need the ID? So that they're able to identify what tribe they come from. Now, folks, there are no two ways here. This is something that must be very strongly condemned by all Kenyans without any fear. Yeah? The government must be condemned. And in the highly unlikely event that they're being framed for this by somebody somewhere, yeah, they still have to be condemned strongly. Why? Because a government is supposed to protect its citizens. I mean, if something like this happens right in the middle of the country's capital city, what are we saying? We are saying that the government has been completely defeated to protect its own citizens. And a government that cannot protect its own citizens has no business being in power. It's as simple as that. Now, this is something that must be very strongly condemned by both sides of the political divide. Now, I need to inform you, or rather tell you something that you may not know. Okay? We have been looking, carefully monitoring the propaganda being spewed out online. Yes? And it would seem that the attacks have been followed by a propaganda program which has an objective of causing even more animosity amongst tribes. How is this being done? It's being done by one of the sides gloating over the killings. Yes? Or rather, these propaganda people are giving the impression that one side is gloating over the killings, which is absolutely not true. Now, one unfortunate thing about propaganda is that when it gathers momentum, it spreads and even ordinary people start talking exactly the way that propaganda is talking. And that's why I'd like to take this opportunity to appeal to all Kenyans to ignore, yeah, this propaganda, and let us all join hands in condemning these killings, yeah, because that's what they are, killings of innocent people. Yes, I don't think a normal person who supports either side of the political divide will support any killings, yeah, and anybody who wants to support those killings, yeah, is just mad. For starters, who tells you you're safe? Yeah, who tells you if you're safe and you're in the country? How can you say you're safe? Who tells you that these killers will not one day find you somewhere and mistake you, yeah, as belonging to a certain community and kill you? Yeah? Who tells you you're safe? And so the wise thing for all of us to do is to completely condemn it and refuse to be provoked. It's interesting that everybody agrees that these killings are politically motivated. Yeah, at least people are confessing and accepting that they're politically motivated, which means that a few people are looking for some certain political objectives. Yeah, they're looking to achieve something. Okay, so let us frustrate them, whatever side of the political divide they come from, let us all frustrate them as the public and refuse to kuingia hiyo box yao, you know, refuse to fall into their neat plans. Not only is that the right thing to do, yeah, it's the only thing to do. But sadly, I know that I'm just wasting my time, yeah, talking to certain people. They already know what they want to do, yes. They'll already support the propaganda by causing provocation, yes, by gloating, yeah. because they want the violence to escalate. I don't know what they want to gain from it all. Yeah, I don't know what they want to gain from the deaths of innocent people. Yes, I don't know if it's blood they drink or they just want to see dead bodies. I don't know what people want. Okay, that is very sad. But I hope and pray that amongst us, there's still some sane, reasonable people left. Yeah, who will realize that this is not the time to push forward your, you know, the push forward your preferred side of the political divide. Yeah, this is the time to save lives and to completely reject cold-blooded killers. Yeah, who are part of a scheme by a few very, very evil politicians. Let me just leave it at that. Until next time, this is Chris Kumekucha.